So originally, I was one of those sheeple thinking that, you know, you had to consume more protein and that would equate to more muscle, more gains. Then I realized that, you know, everything I read from like a clinical study point of view, not necessarily bodybuilding.com, nothing against them. They have a lot of great information. Read from like a lot of other influencers or bodybuilders, they go with like the more is better approach. So, you know, 2 grams, 2 to 3 grams sometime.
For every pound of weight.
For every pound of weight. So if I was 180 pounds, I would need 360 grams of protein, you know, at least. So that's a lot. For a vegan, that's a lot. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, to get that much protein through plants, you got to eat a lot of volume. So I started looking at it and just like, it didn't make sense to me. I was like, everything I read said like there was like an optimal point and anything above that didn't really work to your benefit. You know, you might have extra calories, but your body kind of just like urinates the extra nitrogen and you can't really use it. Like there's a limiting factor there. So I go by lean body mass. So just because somebody's 200 pounds doesn't need to, you don't need to consider them 200 pounds of muscle. You know, we have body fat, so you don't need to feed the body fat. You need to feed the muscle. So I always go by, I calculate my lean body mass, which is your total mass minus your body fat percentage. Mm-hmm. So if I weighed 200 pounds and I was 10% body fat, then I would, my lean body mass would be 180 grams.
Got it. Uh-huh.
So then there's even another fraction that is like 0.8 to 0.9 times that. And that's the number that I go by.
Right. Which is, that's really the like USDA recommendation, right? Or it's like 0.7 grams per kilogram, I think is what they recommend.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm not sure exactly what it translates to in kilograms. I always go by pounds.
Right. Me too.
I weigh 180 pounds right now. I keep my protein at like 150 grams,
uh-huh.
Whether I'm bulking, shredding, 150,
still a lot.
Maybe 160, like somewhere around there.
Uh-huh.
So that's
a typical bodybuilder is taking in about twice that.
Yeah. No, more than twice that because I go by lean body mass.
Right.
So a lot of people calculate it by just total mass.
Uh-huh. And how did you arrive at that? And why have you decided that that's what's optimal for you?
So there's a clinical study out there that references, I don't know the reference, the exact reference, but there's quite a few out there that show that, you know, after a certain point, it doesn't benefit you anymore. Mm-hmm. So I figured why not like find out where that, like I'll use that as a reference and just kind of find out what works best for me. So like I said, I do like a lot of data analysis, tracking and optimization. So there's like certain body scans you can do to track like how much your total mass is and how much of that is muscle mass. So when you're in a deficit, like a caloric deficit, trying to lead up to a show means you have to eat less than what your maintenance calories are. Mm-hmm. So you're going to lose weight. So you want to do that as optimal as possible because you don't want to sacrifice the hard-earned muscle that you just spent the off season trying to gain. So it doesn't make sense to build up 2 pounds of muscle just to lose 2 pounds of muscle mm-hmm. before a show. So there's a balance point there that you have to kind of hover around, and like different scans, like DEXA scans will tell you how much muscle mass you have. In-body scans measures like resistance, muscle impedance, or impedance, and will translate that to how much muscle mass you have on your body, what your bone density is. So I track that. And basically, if I'm losing more muscle than what I want as I'm cutting down for a show, I'll kind of like increase my protein a little bit because that's not the goal. Like I want to maintain that muscle and like mm-hmm. hold on to it and lose the body fat. So I just kind of use that as kind of like nutrition is different for everybody. I can tell you exactly my number. Somebody out there can go follow it. They won't see the same results because everybody responds differently. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of where I just use, you know, trial and error.
Right. Gotcha. And what is the relationship between sourcing your protein from whole foods versus supplements?
Supplements are always going to be a little bit more processed. So different doctors out there, T. Colin Campbell, for one of them, will tell you that, you know, when it's more processed and isolated in its isolated form, your body doesn't necessarily absorb it as efficiently. Mm-hmm. So it's always better to get the whole food source because it contains other chemicals that will help your body absorb that vitamin or mineral or whatever. So that's kind of where it led me to, maybe I'll just go more whole food plant-based and see if I see a difference. And it's the same. So I just kind of shifted all my like more alternative meat style of of nutrition to more whole food plant-based. So that just means that I have to eat more carbs, more beans, more lentils, all the stuff that I love eating, a little bit more tofu and tempeh, mm-hmm. which I love as well. And I see the same results.
Right. And you're in a sport that is terrified of carbs.
Yeah.
So what's the relationship to carbs, and how do you, you know, think about the low carb, no carb craze, and you know, how there's a lot of talk about ketogenic diets and all different kinds of new ways of avoiding carbohydrates in your diet as a means of optimizing performance.
Yeah. I mean, just from like a basic nutrition point of view, like carbs are our energy source. Right. So it doesn't really make sense to cut those all out. There are times when you can manipulate carbs to your advantage, but you don't have to. Like, you don't have to cut out carbs. Like, very much so, people in the fitness industry are carbophobic. So they refuse, like, anything that says carbs in it, they're like, nah, I can't touch it. And anything that has protein in it, they're like, ah, give me more. So my approach is like, first, like, optimize how much protein you need, right? Figure that out first. Most people don't even have any clue.